Hi students, today we are continuing with the discussions of Balban, one of the important ruler of the slave dynasty, and he was also succeeded to lead the consolidation of Delhi Sultanate. We are studying about Balban's theory of kingship. Balban adopted a different theory of kingship based on the principles of blood and iron policy to restoration of power and prestige of the Sultan. Balban's theory of kingship based on two main points. First one, monarchy is bestowed upon a person by the grace of God, hence it is divine. We can say that monarchy was given to a person by the mercy of the God. Only the special person can get to the throne and he will be ruled according to the mercy of the God. Hence, the position of the king was considered as divine. Second one, Sultan must be a despot. Sultan must be an absolute or sovereign power. Balban used to say that king is the representative of God on this earth. The God has sent him to earth to rule the country and he will be representing king, representing God in on earth. Niyabat ki kudai, wise regency of God on earth. The wise person only become a king on this earth, and his dignity nest only to prophethood. Therefore, his action or any deeds or any activities not judged by the people or nobles. He also given importance to king as a shadow of God, dil ilahi. As a representative of God, divine origin theory of kingship, and Sultan was given a special attention to the activities of the people, and also he was guided by God to rule according to the principles of Islam. King is embodiment of despotism. Therefore, he was not answerable to anybody for discharging his duties, functions as a ruler of Delhi. Next one, restoration of the power and prestige of the crown. Many contemporary historians tells us that during the last days of Nasiruddin Muhammad's period, during the period of Nasiruddin Muhammad's rule, the position of Sultan was completely lost his power and respect. The people having no respect to king. Balban expressed his opinion regarding the power and position of the king. He believed that the position of the king was divine. He believed in divine origin theory of kingship and despotic rule. He will be representing God on this earth, and he wanted to rule a despotic nature of rule and complete control over the system of administration. We can say that it is a centralized administration. Balban adopted dignified mode of living. He was wanted to raise the power and prestige of the Sultan. Personally, he decided to change his dress, behavior, habits and activities, and by conducting the affairs of the empire, Balban was given priority to raise the power and prestige of the Sultan. Personally, he was adopted, stop drinking and all luxurious pleasure parties, all enjoyments, all kind of amenities that will king will be directly participating, and the pleasures of the kingdom will be stopped by Balban. He set himself as an example to the people that the king's position was dignified and one of the prestigious position in Delhi. Next, he kept himself away from the people and maintained dignified and reserved. We can say that uncommunicative. He was not easily communicative to the people. The people were not easily approached to the people. He was shown a position of dignified position. To create fear in the minds of the people, he appointed two bodyguards who was always stand by the side of the king, and they were follow the king in every time when the king was conducting darbar or affairs of the empire. Sultan was also went outside, accompanied by bodyguards, marched along with the king and shouting, Bismillah, Bismillah. They wanted to create fear in the minds of the people. They are tall, black, complex, and also having a open sword in their hands. In this way, Balban, with the help of these bodyguards, tried to build an position of the king as one of the dignified position in the empire. He stopped meeting the people also. Automatically, the people were not getting an opportunity to meet the king, and the king was maintained a policy of reserved behavior. Next, the Sultan was also to restore the power and position of the king. He personally changed himself, dress, behavior and manner. He was never come to the court without any royal dress. He was always preferred to wear Persian mode of dress. Balban maintained external and internal dignity, no sorrow, no joy, no smile or no laugh in the court. The dignified court affairs will be conducted by Balban. There is then one example of that. The death of his son, Prince Muhammad, in the year 1286, an encounter with the Mongols. The Balban received the news when he was conducting affairs in the empire, the death of his son, Prince Muhammad. But Balban not shown any kind of sorrow or any kind of expression on his face. He completed all his administrative duties and responsibilities. After end of completion of his administrative responsibilities, returned to his harem, returned to his palace, and alone wept bitterly. That shows that the Balban, having no sign of sorrow expressed by him in front of the people. In court, the court behavior and court dress was fixed for nobles and ministers. The ministers and nobles were not allowed to drinking wine. The wine was prohibited in the empire. The courtiers were also keep standing before the king, no smile, no laugh in the court. Thank you.